As Steve said, I'm Jane Marin, a member of Catholic Charities Board of Directors, and I'm honored to be asked this evening to present the Good Samaritan Award to our recipients. Our first recipients are Chuck and Pat Ernst. Pat and Chuck are both retired math professors from St. Cloud State University. Chuck has been an important volunteer for Catholic Charities Emergency Services since 1996. Although Chuck typically is scheduled one day a week as a volunteer, we've been told that staff can call on Chuck at the last minute and he'll always come in. As you'll see during our video, Chuck's passion is working with clients and helping people in their time of need. Yes, he'll do office work too, but he really enjoys working with clients. Not only are Chuck and Pat actively supporting Catholic Charities, but they also help our community in other ways. For many years, Pat has volunteered at the Whitney Senior Citizen Center for the Volunteer Income Tax Assistance Program and actually was instrumental in starting that program. As members of Christ Church Women's Center, they're involved in the community meal, which helps feed members of our community in need of food and in fellowship. Chuck and Pat are advocates in the community for our Catholic Charities and have supported Catholic Charities financially for more than 20 years. They are members of our Circle of Hope and the Evergreen Leadership Society. Let's watch and learn more about Chuck and Pat Ernst.
We are Chuck and Pat Ernst, and we live in Southeast St. Cloud. We didn't grow up here, but the last time we moved to St. Cloud was 1968, when I took a position at the university teaching mathematics in the mathematics department. And Pat joined me soon after after she finished raising five kids and going back to school and getting her degrees. We are both math professors. We both retired from the math department at St. Cloud State in 1995, and we came to Catholic Charities the following year, and we've been volunteering at Catholic Charities. I've been volunteering at Catholic Charities ever since. Pat has been doing something else. She's been running the tax aid program at Whitney for all this time.
I work with Chuck at the intake desk. Chuck does intake for clients when they come in to check in for food and clothing, and he is just a joy to be around. He lights up the building when he walks in the room.
We're members of Christ Church Women's Center, and we've been there a long time. In fact, we were there before the building was there as students.
Chuck loves the clients. He is so wonderful with all our clients. They know him, they come in, he knows their names. They give him a little bit of grief now and then, and he gives it back.
In a previous life, I was a member of the board of RSVP for a couple of terms, and so I knew about all of the agencies in town that were doing charity work when we retired, and that was one of the first places I went at Catholic Charities, because I knew that they were good agencies. When I came here in 1996, I said, I'd kind of like to volunteer here, but I have to have contact with clients. I can still do, I can hang clothes or I can stock shelves, but I have to have contact with clients.
Chuck is the very definition of a good Samaritan. I often think that one day I'm going to watch him walk out without the shirt on his back because he's giving it to someone. It's just a great picture of a day.
You don't ask him what to say, anything about your face. Oh, I find them to have very strong faith, generally. The clients, people who come, they're in need. So what do they look? They look to God a lot more than I do.
Chuck is such a wonderful person. He's humble and kind. I just can't say enough about Chuck.
They need God working through us. This part of what I see this project. There are so many good volunteers here that could receive this award. I don't know why they pick on me. I don't know that I need the recognition for it. I don't know. That's not something I'm working for. I'm looking for a recognition in the next world.
Usually, seven children, for the most part, on one teacher's salary. And now, we have money we don't need. Our children are all doing well. So we just feel it's our obligation to give money because we have it.
When the pandemic occurred, we pretty much shut down except for basic staff, and we figured out how to just get some food out to people. And then they emerged or evolved to, we would fill carts of food.
During the pandemic, they kicked us all out. Volunteers all out. So the staff did all the buses and the food.
We wear masks and sanitize everything. We had strict rules, and a couple volunteers came back throughout that to help us fill these carts.
Not us for a year probably, and then some of the volunteers coming back and doing some of the things. And so it's a different program today.
Chuck was going so crazy at home. I know he was. He just wants to be out and involved.
They were leaving people out the door or outside.
Yeah. Even in the cold winter. And they was at the door. Well, now they're back in the building. And they are picking their own food off the food shelf now, but not in such great numbers so that they're crowded together.
Chuck has volunteered over 6,000 hours at emergency services. He has done a variety of things. He has hanged clothes in the clothing program. He has done filing for me, which I think he's kind of decided he's done doing that. But $200, that's an amazing amount of time that he's gifted us. I love Chuck and Pat. They are such a gift to us, just in spirit, in humbleness. I know they didn't even want to be in front of this camera today because they want their giving to be not the highlight of their life. They just want to do it. We just so appreciate them at Catholic Charities. They're wonderful people.
Oftentimes, we're so wrapped up in our own lives that we forget about those who are less fortunate, but not Chuck and Pat. They're kind, their acts of kindness towards others without expecting ever heard any recognition in return is truly the act of Good Samaritan. Please join me in welcoming to the stage and congratulating Chuck and Pat. So I pretty much knew Catholic Charities was where I wanted to go.
when I retire. And so I so appreciate the fact that Catholic Charities gave me a second vocation when I retired from my first one. So I was able to spend all that time working for others at Catholic Charities. Pat had three vocations. She started out staying home for 20 years or so, raising seven kids, and then got a degree and taught for 20 years. And then she went to work for tax aid at Whitney, not just volunteering, but actually running the program. She and Mary Ann Leach ran that program for 25 years at least, and they finally got somebody to take it over. She was really doing a great job during this COVID time. She was so glad she didn't have to do it during COVID, mm-hmm. but they figured out a way to do it. It's getting done yet. But they were doing taxes for like 2,000 individuals a year, low income and elderly. So another great program. It's not a Catholic Charities program, but it's still a good volunteer. Okay, my time's up.